being unsuccessful is not a coincidence. Interestingly enough, it can actually be the catalyst for people to excel. And this will only happen if you are aware of the surroundings, if you're aware of how you individually stand in those surroundings, if you're aware of the tools that you have at your availability, and also this personal desire, this personal drive to excel, to be the best, to give it all you got. And you'll see in the end that that will lead to winning. The boat is business. We need investors to start campaigns. Companies need investors to start off. We need a crew on a boat. A crew that needs to work together. A company needs employees to be successful. A boat has direction. It likes to sail forward. It doesn't like to drift sideways. A company definitely does not want to stand still. It wants to move forward to be successful. A boat has to use the conditions that there are, the storms, to win a race. A company needs to tech in the marketplace, needs to check what the competitors are doing, needs to deal with the stock exchange. In the end, to be successful, we have to decide what do we want to do, what is our goal, whether you're a sailboat, whether you're a company. Feeling like a hand in rusted chain, so do you laugh or does it cry? On a sailboat, we have many, many egos. And maybe interestingly enough, you don't have this in a company, do you? But to be successful with all these personalities, we have to define a common goal. And you can question yourself, what is that common goal? Is that goal to be the best at what you do? Does the company win then? Does the boat win then? Is the goal to have the strongest department, to have the department with the best result? Does the boat win then? We don't think so in sailing. On a sailboat, we'd like to make sure that there's not a weakest link. We'd like to make sure that the helmsman does not need to be the best, but needs to be as good as the trimmer, as the mast maker, as the hydraulic expert. We'd like to have all the divisions on the boat, all the egos, to be at the same level, to consistently get better, to get to 80%, 90%, 95% together, and not to have a weakest link. So in the end, the goal of a sailboat is not for one person, one division to be the best, but the goal of a sailboat is to get the first meter of our boat first across the finish line. In ocean racing, you will not win if you're not a good team. Together, each will achieve, and you will do that more. The abbreviation of team. Together, each achieves more. E, the interesting one, the individual. I believe the team is made up of the individual. And what you see then on the boat is that you have a lot of respect growing between team members. Respect not because of who they are or what they are, but respect because of knowledge of what they do for the performance of the boat. And if everybody has this respect, we get this consistency. Consistency in performance, consistency in the end in results. And if you're consistent, you win. In this game of life, we gon' play ball. Us against them, we gon' lay them all. We will not be the losers. Preparation is 70% of the success, which basically means that you don't leave any stone unturned before you get to the start line. It also means that you need time and the financial resources. Time to grow the team, time to grow the product, to make the product, to learn to work together. At the same time, also the financial resources at the right time. Being able to spend the money when you need it, not when you get it. And last, but by no means least, a good preparation means you have to prepare for the worst situation. In sailing, it is very easy, when it's a very predictable environment, to be good. Everybody can be good then. But the true champions are those that win in the storm. This means in your preparation, you have to find out how strong the boat is. You have to push the boat. You have to find out where the edge is. This is Roy Heiner, a professional yachtsman, wishing you all the best in your journey to find out that success is not a coincidence.